Here in Higglytown, things all jump around, just like the Higglytown heroes. They all work together, making fun together. Come see the Higglytown heroes. You be Wayne, Twinkle, Kip, and Fran, all hop and pop around. Soon they'll learn about real heroes, who and why and how. Now, here in Higglytown, we'll all jump around and meet the Higglytown heroes. We'll all work together, having fun together with all the Higglytown heroes. Let's all play together, save the day together. Come join the Higglytown heroes.
Twinkle's masterpiece.
Gee, Mom, don't we even get a hint where we're going?
No, I told you, it's a surprise. You'll see when we get there.
Can anyone guess where we're going?
Oh, I hope we're going to the Pink Puppy Poodle Palace so we can see all the pink poodles.
You don't have to guess anymore, kids. We're here. This is where my friend Nikki lives. She's an artist, and she's gonna give you art lessons.
Art lessons?
Cool!
Wow, you're right on time. Hey there, future artists. I'm Nikki.
Hi, Nikki.
Wow.
Are you looking at my statue?
Go ahead, you can touch it.
Okay, everyone. I'll be back in an hour. Have fun.
Bye, Mom.
Now let's all go into my studio. That's where we make art happen.
Wow!
Is that a real dog? Or did you make him too?
Oh, you mean Clarence. He's a real doggy, all right. He just likes to sleep in here where it's nice and warm.
Did you see this paint is the exact same color as my shirt?
Actually, I can't see it because I'm blind.
You mean you can't see?
That's right. It's the way I was born.
But if you can't see, how do you get around your house?
I can't see, but I can still hear and touch and smell. Besides, I know where everything is. This is my clay and my tools. And this is where I do my pottery.
I see how you can find your way around. But if you can't see, how can you make art?
That's a good question, Twinkle. Why don't you all close your eyes? Here, now put out your hands.
Huh? What?
Hey, what's this?
It feels squishy.
It's clay. Now, with your eyes shut, try to make shapes with it. Now, let's see those shapes.
I made an acorn shape.
I made a space alien.
I think.
See? Even without looking, you all made wonderful shapes. You can use more than just your eyes to make amazing works of art.
Yeah!
What are we all waiting for? Let's go make some art.
You can make art in so many ways.
We can make art in so many ways.
You can have such exciting days making new things. You'll be so amazed.
Our hands and our ears can also be guides to help us create from our feelings inside. We can make art in so many ways. We can make art in so many ways.
I use bouncy springs to give my robot arms that swing.
Here's a bird with foil wings. To make them flap, I pulled the string.
I put chills on a ball of clay. What it is, I cannot say. Listen when I tap it with a stick.
I love to hear the way they click. With acorns, I made a treat. It's a necklace that I can wear and eat.
Buttons for eyes, yarn for hair. A velvet dress will add more flair. A fairy with some paper wings. I fly her around on a sparkly string.
making new things, you'll be so amazed.
Our hands and our ears can also be guides to help us create from our feelings inside. We can make art in so many ways.
There! Feel what I made, Nikki? She's a beautiful fairy lady princess.
Wow, Twinkle, that's really fantastic. I just adore her crinkly dress and her smooth wings, too.
I made it for my mom. She was super nice to surprise us with art lessons. So tonight at dinner, I'm gonna surprise her with my art.
That's a sweet idea, Twinkle.
The doorbell! Is it Mom already?
Promise not to tell her about my surprise.
We promise!
I solemnly swear to zip my lip.
Quick! Hide my fairy lady surprise!
Hurry! She's coming!
Oh no! Here she comes!
Hi! Did you kids have a good time?
Oh, yeah. I made a robot, see?
And I made a flappy flapping bird.
And I made
I'm not sure what it is.
They're all just wonderful. Twinkle, what did you make?
Mine? Well, it's not exactly ready for you to see it yet.
Well, I can't wait to see it. But now it's time to get going. Bye, Nikki. See you next time.
Goodbye, Nikki.
Bye-bye. Mwah, mwah.
Thanks for taking us to art lessons, Mom. Now we're gonna play outside, okay?
Okay, kids. Have fun.
Quick, Kip. Give me my fairy lady princess so I can hide it until dinner time.
But I gave it to Wayne.
I gave it to Yubi.
But I gave it to... Uh-oh.
What do you mean, uh-oh?
I mean, I hid it in one of Nikki's statues, back at Nikki's house.
Oh, no! What do we do?
That's easy. Just ask your mom to drive us back there to pick it up.
But we can't! She'll see it! And it's supposed to be a surprise, remember?
Surprise?
Pizza guy!
Maybe you could give your mom a super surprise supreme. It's a work of art.
Thanks, pizza guy, but I really wanted to give her my fairy lady princess.
And that's okay. More pizza for me. Cheese you later. Whoa!
There must be a way we could get Twinkle's art back.
Oh, oh, I know, I know, I know. First, we use an extra fast rocket ship to blast off to the moon. Then, we get the jumpy moon monkeys to help us. We'd lower one down on a super big fishing rod. Then, he could grab hold of my fairy lady princess with his tail, and I would pull him back up. Whoosh!
That's a far-out idea there, Twinkle. Only there's one teeny tiny problem. We don't know any moon monkeys.
Pickles.
Maybe you could just call Nikki and see if she wouldn't mind bringing your fairy lady here.
Hey, why didn't we think of that?
Here, I put her on speed dial.
Hi, Nikki. It's me, Twinkle. I forgot my fairy lady princess at your house. Uh-huh. She says she can bring it over now.
But how can she find her way here? She can't see, remember?
Yeah, she'll get lost.
Oh, you're right. Nikki, how are you going to get here by yourself? It's okay. She says she has the help of someone special.
Someone special? Who could it be?
This job's too big for you and me.
We need some help.
But never fear, oh. It looks like a job for a Higglytown hero.
A Higglytown hero.
It's my seeing eye dog, Clarence. He's a Higglytown hero, brave and true. He helps me out with the things I do. So work real hard and you will see that you can be a hero, just like he. A hero, yes siree.
He's a seeing eye dog, don't you know? He helps me get where I need to go. He knows when I tell him left or right. He leads me safely day or night. Clarence here's not just a pet. He'll never let me down, you bet. He acts just like two eyes for me and looks for dangers I can't see.
Can he show you where to go in the ice and the snow?
Could he guide you back home if you're lost in Rome?
In the snow or far off lands, he's right here to lend a hand. It's his job to help and guide, always with me by my side. He's a Higglytown hero, bold and good. He helps his friend just like he should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero, just like you. A hero just like you.
And now, Twinkle, I think Clarence has something you need.
It's my fairy lady princess. Thank you, Nikki.
You're very welcome.
And thank you, Clarence. Without you, I'd never be able to give my mom my special surprise.
Why, Nikki, what are you doing here?
She came to bring my special surprise.
What surprise?
Oh, I was gonna give this to you at dinner, but look. It's a fairy lady princess. I made it for you, to thank you for taking us to art class.
Wow, sweetie. She's just beautiful. That was so kind and thoughtful. You're my very own Higglytown hero.
Oh, I can't wait for our next art class. I know just what I'm gonna make.
What's that, Twinkle?
I want to make a statue of Clarence.
The Egg-cellent Adventure.
Are we almost there yet, Wayne and Twinkle's Uncle Limo?
Almost.
Can we open our eyes yet?
Not till I say, or you'll ruin the surprise. Okay, here we are. Everybody ready? 1, 2, 3, look!
Uncle Limo's diner!
Anybody hungry for breakfast? I'm cooking.
Yeah!
This is what I call fun.
This is what I call dizzy.
Morning, folks. Want to hear our breakfast specials?
You betcha.
We got eggs and bacon, eggs and cheese, eggs and taters, eggs and beets, eggs and gravy, eggs and grits, eggs and tofu, eggs and toast, eggs and carrots, eggs and peas, eggs and waffles, eggs and beans, eggs and tuna, eggs and ketchup, eggs any way that you please.
Wow, you sure have a lot of eggs.
You can say that again.
My pleasure. We got eggs and bacon, eggs and cheese, eggs and taters, eggs and beets, eggs and gravy, eggs and grits, eggs and tofu, eggs and toast, eggs and carrots, eggs and peas, eggs and waffles, eggs and beans, eggs and tuna, eggs and ketchup, eggs any way that you please. Okay, who's ready to order?
I want an egg with bacon.
Hey, Limo, break one and toss on two logs.
Coming right up.
I want two eggs. Scrambled, please.
Break another two, and this time, wreck 'em.
No problem.
I want three eggs, two donuts, and one big glass of orange juice.
Break three, toss them two life preservers, and a tall sunshine.
Coming right up.
Excuse me, Ms. Waitress, but what are you talking about?
Why, we're talking about your breakfasts.
You are?
Yep, but we're talking in a special secret code called slang.
Ooh.
Slang is kind of like words in disguise. On the outside, it sounds like we're talking about one thing.
Life preservers?
But really, we're talking about something else.
Donuts!
Bingo bongo! I think they got it.
So why do you talk in slang?
Why?
Because it's fun!
Food around here has funny names. One thing. Sure, they mean the same.
It's not very hard to learn our silly names.
So if you want to learn, just join and play our game.
Break a rock and add two sticks.
That's an egg with two strips of bacon.
Ha ha! Fresh moon juice in a glass.
means I'm pouring up a glass of milk.
Two life preservers and make them walk.
Here's your donuts to go. Delicious.
I need a raft with a shaky stuff.
Toast and jelly coming up.
It's not very hard to learn our silly names. So if you want to learn, join and play the game.
I want to walk a dog through the garden.
You want a hot dog with some relish.
Uh-huh. Want balloon juice? Hold the hail.
Soda water with no ice.
Give me some rabbit food on my sandwich.
You want to add some lettuce to it.
Put a hat on my root beer pop.
Hey, you want a scoop of ice cream on top.
You
lunch. We sure got a bunch.
And if you come for dinner, we know you'll learn a winner. So what'll it be, Wayne?
Walk two, put them on a raft, and don't forget the shaky stuff.
Got it. Two fried eggs on toast, and don't forget the jelly. Hey!
Mmm, I can almost taste those eggs right now.
Yeah, me too.
Say it isn't so!
What's the matter?
Oh, bad news, kids. We're 86 on the eggs.
86? But that's the secret code for you're out of eggs.
Yep. I'm afraid they're all gone.
But if the eggs are all gone, what are we gonna eat? How about pancakes?
Sorry, Kip. You need eggs to make pancakes.
How about waffles?
You need eggs to make waffles, too.
How about toast?
That depends. Did you want toasted egg bread?
Aww. This is awful. Without eggs, there's nothing to eat for breakfast.
And I've got nothing to cook.
If only there was something we could do.
Well, why don't we find more eggs?
Hey, yeah!
No eggs in this mailbox.
No eggs in this flower.
Whoopsie.
No eggs under Pizza Guy's hat.
That's where I keep my frozen pizza pops. Yum!
Where should we look now, Fran?
Well, let's think. Where can you usually find eggs?
Neatly organized in an egg carton?
In a grocery store?
An egg-juggling circus clown?
Can't hurt to try.
Oh, looks like I'll be juggling melons again.
Well, this is quite a puzzle, kids. We've looked up, we've looked down.
We've even looked inside a clown.
But we just can't find any eggs.
Where, oh, where could they be?
Oh, I know!
Maybe they got lost.
Maybe they were sailing the seas on their sparkly sailboat, the Broken Yoke. When they stopped to ask an octopus for directions. Which, by the way, is the last person you ever want to ask. The poor eggs didn't know which way to go. And were soon shipwrecked on a deserted island.
We're lost! Oh, pickles!
So all we have to do is make a nice big piece of toast.
Toast?
So the eggs can use it as a raft to float back home. Well, what do you think?
I think that's one humdinger of a plan there, Twinkle. But there's also one humdinger of a problem. Your toast will get soggy and sink.
Oh, pickles. This is terrible. If we don't find more eggs, then the dino will never be able to make us breakfast. And if we never eat breakfast, our stomachs will grumble until lunchtime. What
did I tell you?
I don't know about you guys, but I think we could use some help.
Some special help.
Someone special, who could it be?
This job's too big for you and me.
We need some help.
But never fear, oh.
It looks like a job for Higglytown Hero.
A Higglytown Hero.
Grandpa Crank? You're a Higglytown Hero?
Why, of course, Yubi. I'm a chicken farmer. I'm a Higglytown Hero, brave and true. I help the town with the things I do. So work real hard and you will see that you can be a hero just like me. A hero just like me. I'm a chicken farmer and I raise hens. Hens lay eggs, 8, 9, or 10. Eggs are what we like to eat. Omelettes and breakfast treats. I give my hens just what they need. Lots of love and chicken feed. At night they go into their coop and live in one big feathered group.
Could a hen without a nest lay eggs in the Wild West?
Could a hen that's pink and white lay eggs upon a kite?
Pink dot hen or cowgirl chicks, they lay eggs in hay and sticks all day long and nighttime too. Laying eggs is what they do. I'm a Higglytown Hero, bold and good. I help my friends just like I should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero just like you. A hero just like you.
My goodness. Will you look at all those eggs?
There's enough to make breakfast for everyone in Higglytown!
We were hoping you'd say that.
Yeah!
And fruit for everyone, coming right up!
Thanks, Grandpa Crank, for helping us find more eggs.
Why, it was my pleasure, kids. But I think the real ones to thank are Mrs. Cluck and all her hen friends. They did all the work.
Thanks, Mrs. Cluck!
That's secret code for you're welcome.
Okay, here you go, folks.
Breakfast!
Hen fruit for you. Hen fruit for you. Hen fruit for you and you. And a stack of patches for you with extra tree sap.
This is what I call yummy. Oh.
Thank you, Miss Waitress and Uncle Lemo. This was the best breakfast we ever ate.
Well, I'm glad you like it, kids, because breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
That's right. So remember to always eat a good breakfast, and you can be...
Higglytown Heroes!